Some of you guys might have clicked on this video because of the thumbnail, the opening picture. My brother Curtis sent me that picture. That deer was on his lawn in the city, and I thought it was just such a beautiful picture. So I thought I'd share it with you guys. And as I butcher, I was thinking about, was butchering yesterday, I was thinking about Curtis, because he always loved to butcher. So come along with us today as we butcher, teach you how we butcher a deer on the Great Oak Ranch. So here's a few things you're going to need for butchering. You're going to need some boning knives. You're going to need, and you can do this any way you want. This is just how I do it. Scrap bucket. I throw out all the deer fat. Deer fat is not like beef fat. That's where people feel they get the wild game. And then you want your sausage bucket. And you might want a saw, depending on how you do your cuts. This is a knife kit. The other thing you're gonna want is some string for tying rows. And you're gonna want a steel to sharpen your knife. You gotta keep a real sharp knife. And the other thing you need is a guard dog that is drooling lip to lip. We'll see if we can train her. She thinks I'm the alpha, so we might give her a bone to chew on. What do you think, Ruby? Good deal? Sounds good. Okay. Right here is why a predator will eat the guts out of an animal first to get to those tenderloins. Right, Ruby? You guys probably like my hairdo, but it's late, 10:30, and we're butchering a deer. And these tenderloins won't last too long, guaranteed. These are for a special day, so for birthdays. So Brody and Michaela's birthday are coming up here in December, so they usually don't get through December. But come along today as we try our best to teach you how to butcher a deer and the best, least amount of waste with the best cuts that we find on the Great Hope Ranch. It might not be the right way, but this is what we do anyways. Come along. As we cut these up here, I want to show you guys. When you cut these loins, this silver skin is what people don't like, and it's chewy. But if you get a, usually I just trim it off here, like I'm doing here, and I put it into the sausage meat. This is the scraps, and you can see all the fat that we got in there. But this is what your sirloin should look. I like to freeze it just like that. If you freeze the sirloin just like that, you can do so many things with it. And we've freezed them, and we've opened them, and stuffed them, and smoked them. You know, we've had company over sometimes, and it doesn't bother me one bit if they don't want to eat it, because it's so good. And right, Ruby? It don't bother us one bit, does it, if they don't want to eat it? More for me and you, right? She's doing so good. There's raw meat on here. Poor dog. She's just sitting there. Last night we pulled the back straps off this for the stakes and we sirloined them. Now we're gonna cut the rest of it up. We've just finished doing one shoulder. We pulled the tenderloins off here and we just finished doing that shoulder right there. And we're gonna do another one now. But here's what you need to know. This is the temperature in the shop. This is a refrigerator thermometer. So if it's in the green, the temperature's good. We don't have a cooler in here, something to cool it down. There's no heat in here right now. And the weather's starting to get warm. So that's why we're getting this cut up. All what you do is you pull the armpit apart here and you start to go up the armpit as you cut and it's gonna spread. So you go up the armpit like so. And you're gonna come back around. We're gonna go right here where the exit wound was and continue to go up. And it's almost just like skinning the deer. Now the reason why I'm showing you guys this is just how simple it is to do a deer. A lot of guys are taking, not trying to take work away from anybody, but if you can't afford to take these animals to the butcher, you should be able to do it on your own. So that shoulder's off, we're gonna go in and cut it up.
Good girl, Ruby. Sit, stay there. You're welcome. One thing I wanted to mention to you guys, I like to put a plastic bag in this bin so that when you freeze it, it will be a block and then you can take the bag out and reuse the bin. And it also is another sense to keep everything clean. So we pretty much got that shoulder trimmed up. We got some stuff to trim up over there. And everybody's happy, right, Ruby? Right? Good girl.
Just wanted to mention that Ryan, he ended up taking a muley buck here just behind the shop last year. And I videoed it because I thought it was kind of funny. And he thought I'd make fun of him. This is for you, Ryan. I had no thought of making a YouTube channel before that, so it was just a joke and everything that way. But it actually wasn't a joke, because Ryan did a really good job dressing this animal out. He wanted to practice it, because he lives out by Cochrane, for when he's deep in the bush, and he wanted to practice it. And the best way to practice it is right there, other than in the deep bush where you could have a grizzly bear around and you're nervous about it. So, anyways, we're gonna take the rib cage now. We're gonna take it into the, and show you guys how that looks. We basically took the saw and we cut the spine right there. And then we can take the hind quarters off and take them in after where the pelvis is at. We're gonna take this rib cage in and most of this is sausage meat here now. We've taken the steaks off. Everything on the neck is tough from these running bucks. So it's all gonna be sausage meat. So this is how it's gonna look. Always cut away for himself towards your buddy, right?
Let me video this. We are gonna make a YouTube channel. This is how we have walked 23 miles. We camped 4 nights. And finally Ryan found this monster buck. If you like this video, make sure you click on the bottom of the screen, hit the icon, and make sure you subscribe. Now this is how you dress out a deer. This is gonna take us days to get them out of here. So we're packing them out in bags. We got all the meat here in bags. look at these hindquarters, beautiful. Beautiful meat. And even you can do this if you get off your couch and stop watching YouTube. What do you think, Ryan? What? You're gonna be a millionaire after this video, so you gotta say something. You know how many hits we're gonna get on this baby? I don't think so.
Actually,
the truth is, you can see that you can see the peak of the roof of the chop right there in the yard. Okay, that just ruined the video. But make sure you comment at the bottom how you like this video. Look at this muley. What a tree raker. Now the last two quarters. Just a little tip. If you're butchering and you're not going to get it all done in one shot, always leave this one till last. I'll tell you this from experience. Conservation officer shows up your door. The tag is still on it. You leave this one hanging there when he shows up. He's going to have some questions. So we're pretty much done here. We got a couple ropes to tie and some steaks to cut, and then vacuum pack. And then this goes in the freezer here. You know, the biggest reason I think to show you guys this is for some of you who don't hunt, you probably watched that solo hunt video and you can't make sense of it. This is a very important part of the hunt, and this is part that this is the part that actually gets missed more often than not. This is the important part. This is why our ancestors hunt, went out and hunted, and they to feed themselves. And one of the neighbors said here, just I was on the phone with them last night, and they said, you know, if worse gets to worse, we can always hunt. We have deer, we have wildlife out here. And these are valuable tools that we can take if the grocery stores aren't available anymore. So we're gonna have a bunch of sausage. We got some antelope sausage in there. We'll have to buy some pork or get a pork to butcher. Usually the Hutterites have them, and when I take Cayutes down there, I can buy a pork off of them and do the same thing. But thanks for coming along today. And we're gonna tie these off and get to bed. What do you say, Ruby? Call it a night? Sounds good. Well, fellas, essentially we're out of time. All we had is a few roasts to tie, but the reality is that I'm gonna spare you the pain of me tying roasts. I can make the knot okay, but I know one guy who can make the knot a lot better, and that's Mum's cousin, Wayne. So make sure you give him a call at 1-306-2585-32482.